This presentation is based around the many unique components that are featured in the Yamaha MRX7-D. Many of these components are designed specifically for audio conference systems, including the Dugan Auto Mixer, for example. Here, we'll describe the design of a medium-sized conference system, a voice lift conference system that combines these MRX7-D components. We will explain about designed as an MRX7-D conference system solution. A voice lift conference system, which is a personal amplification conference system that allows the voices of participants to be faithfully and naturally delivered over a wide area. This video explains the design and adjustment methods used on a personal amplification system for an average size conference room of up to 40 people. To start off, I'll explain a voice lift system using standard gooseneck microphones, and then we'll look at some choices in the system's options. We'll take a look at important points in the system design, equipment configuration, mic and speaker placement, and configuration explanations and setting methods. For conferences with many participants, there are many instances when the participants are far away from each other and the voice of the person speaking is hard to hear. In this situation, we can make the conference run much more smoothly by amplifying the voice of each participant. That said, using multiple mics and speakers increases the chances of feedback as the mics and speakers are located more closely together. We need to amplify the participants' voices sufficiently whilst keeping down the feedback. This system uses gooseneck mics and ceiling speakers to make the voice lift conference system, whilst components from the MRX7-D are used to keep the feedback down. In the system overview, we can see the projected conference size is for 24 people, and there's one gooseneck mic used per person. Ceiling speakers are used to amplify the voices of the person who is speaking, and two approaches are used to reduce feedback. The first is how we place the mics and speakers, and the second is signal processing using the MRX7-D's processor. For the DSP, we use the MRX7-D's feedback suppressor, Dugan Auto Mixer, and the Matrix Mixer components. We'll explain how to use each component in detail later. Here, we see the equipment configuration. 24 gooseneck mics are used for input, and 10 ceiling speakers are connected for output. Two EXI-8 units are used to increase the number of mics that can be connected to the MRX7-D. The analog mic signals are converted to the digital WIDIF format and sent to the MRX7-D, after which digital signal processing is applied, and the signals are then sent to the XMV amplifiers, again using Yamaha's proprietary WIDIF digital connection. When using gooseneck mics, place one mic per person, and avoid having multiple people share a single gooseneck mic, as this results in a loss of sound clarity. Regarding speaker placement, we recommend that the ceiling speakers are placed for maximum overlap in order to amplify the sound at a consistent volume to all seats. By using a matrix mixer, we can determine the area to output the audio for each mic. By switching off output to the speakers nearest to each mic, we can keep the feedback down. We'll explain the setup method later. In this example, connect each speaker using low impedance to each amplifier channel, so that each speaker can be separately turned on or off. This is the configuration for the MRX7-D that makes voice lift a reality. The major components used include the Dugan Auto Mixer, Pitch Shift Feedback Suppressor, Matrix Mixer, Speaker Processor, and so on. Next, we will explain about the individual roles and setup for each component. First, we'll explain the Dugan Auto Mixer. The Dugan Auto Mixer automatically adjusts the gain on each mic, so that the total mix gain remains at a fixed level. This keeps the howling or feedback margin at a fixed level while increasing the signal-to-noise ratio, amplifying the sound in a clearer, more stable way. Use gain share on all the mics as a single group and output the signals individually from their discrete outs rather than from the group mix out. To suppress howling or feedback, insert a feedback suppressor for each mic source. Two types of feedback suppressor can be used on the MRX7-D, a notch feedback suppressor and a pitch shift feedback suppressor. However, for this example, we recommend using the pitch shift feedback suppressor, which has a few limitations regarding the number used and does not require pre-tuning. Select speech mode. Then, adjust the suppression level to an appropriate value, within the range where the amplified sound is not unnatural sounding. We'll explain about the matrix mixer. Of course, the more that the sound amplified by the speakers is picked up by the mics, the greater the tendency for howling to occur. For this reason, moving the speaker away from the mic is an effective way to create stable amplified sound. Here we'll explain how to use the matrix mixer to appropriately set the amplification range for each mic, in order to keep the speakers and mics at a specific or greater distance from each other. To reduce the amount of sound that is picked up by a mic, mute the speaker that is closest to the mic. For instance, when a mic is located directly underneath a speaker, mute only the speaker directly above. When a mic is located in the vicinity between speakers, mute the closest two speakers. Set all of the mics in this way. This example shows the matrix mixer settings, with a combination of 24 mics and 10 ceiling speakers. If howling is still a problem, even after following these steps, try widening the range of speakers that are muted.